for CMDA Cross River, one thing some years back we had told ourselves when we gathered and we were praying was, we said, Lord, can you use us as a case study to show everyone what you can do with a people?
You see that they are so active in the department that nothing can actually be done without their input.
So CMDA Cross River State is just one of those chapters that you can't help but love. The warmth, you know, the care, concern for members, and then the integration, how they get around working with students, the doctors and students, the way they get into the hospital itself, where many of them function, and the society. They are part of their community. And you hear people talk about their families when they are together. It's just a beautiful family, really. I've been with them a number of times, and it's always a joy to go back there, because, you know, that has been one of our model chapters, and we hope that many other chapters will look at what they are doing and learn a lot from what's going on amongst them.
I am the CMDA chairman for Cross River State. I work with the University of Calabar as a lecturer, and I work with the teaching hospital as an honorary consultant community public health physician.
I am Dr. Patience Odusolu, the vice chairman of CMDA Cross River State branch. I am an associate professor with the University of Calabar and chief consultant in the Teaching Hospital Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology.
It's been a full packed year for us. Starting usually in January, we hold our annual retreat, where for about 2 days we converge in a very beautiful spot, serene environment close to the coast area from where the slaves were initially moved many years back, where we kind of brainstorm and pray together as a school and plan for the whole year.
One thing that we try to do in the branch is to try and do things together with the student arm of CMDA. So most of the activities we have are joint activities.
We were able to carry out a one-day medical outreach to a place in celebration of CMDA at 50. We also carried out other programs such as the basic life support for health workers in the whole Cross River State that involved getting people from different institutions, private institutions, the teaching hospitals, the military hospitals, the private hospitals and others. So we asked them to nominate people, and we trained them on the basic life support program, which was certificated based on American Heart Association standard. That and also had some deep interactions with the emergency department in the University of Calabar Teaching Hospital. We've also hosted the CEO for a Meet the CEO event, where he came and had interactions with the brethren and everybody. We've fully been utilizing our command center for capacity building trainings and other things. We started doing what we call like prayer walks around the hospital. Every quarter we go around, and then of course we now hold prayers every Friday, the general house, apart from the school prayers. And then we've had a lot of partnership missions with other bodies. Then we started something interesting which we feel could help in solidifying the bond between the doctor's arm and the student's arm, which is like every month, once every Saturday in every month, we hold a fitness CMDA Fitness Day.
So this usually involves the students and the doctors. So it's like, if only bring us together, we interact. At that point, nobody knows who is the doctor and who is the student. We are all together trying to keep fit. Okay, and then at the end of the exercise, if it is water we have or some snacks, we share together in love. And then, so that has really helped us in bonding together.
The hurdle we've had for me majorly has been the strike. The strike has just been, it's unfortunate that we could have such a length of time that productive people are just kept at home. But I think that was the biggest challenge or hurdle we've been able to have. But God being kind, the strike has been called off, activities have started again. We've also had loss of our brethren migrate out of the country. So friends, colleagues, and I think that also has increased the workload for the few people left. That has also created some challenge for us, for instance, for the outreach that we planned. We were supposed to have surgeries. Because we don't have anesthesiologists again, unlike before in numbers, we had to reschedule or cancel over 8 surgeries that we have planned to do. We had the surgeons available, everything was available. But the anesthesiologist, the only one that was available that had done for the first day, was not available for the second day. We started a concept that we started the year before, which was that we wanted to change the narrative whereby for CMDA bonus outreach, which is like our flagship outreaches, right? Where literally before, the students organize and plan, and the doctors just add one or two inputs. So what we wanted to recreate was a more balanced equation that got more doctors involved in the planning to bring in their wealth of expertise. So we now recreated everything, whereby we created a three-step layer. On the top layer was what we called the CMD Bonus LOC Policy Group, which includes the CMD doctors in schools, the LOC doctors, because we now have doctors LOC for the mission outreach, then the student executives, they are core CEC members, and then the people we call project managers, one from the doctor's arm and one from the student arm, and then the LOC chairman. Then below that level, there's a tactical level, which now encompasses more of the LOC people, the chairman, from both the doctor's arm and the student's arm and all of that. And then the last layer is, of course, the student's layer. So actually, the reason why it is that way is that at the lower level is the operational level, which for us is the student's LOC. As you go up, what their own is about giving vision and direction to how the outreach should run. And it's been quite interesting looking at the way it has also helped, unlike previous years, to have more doctors from the onset being involved, while also being careful not to minimize or reduce the voices of the students, because trying to balance the experience and advisory capacity of the doctors with the rich resources they come with, which at times is not just about money, it also may mean in terms of their network from the onset, and then balancing that with the energy and the enthusiasm and the creativity and the innovation of the students, and marrying the two together. At times, what has evolved out is trying to solve a problem we notice. So we were discussing about the surgeries we had to carry out, and we realized, wait a minute, you can't really do major surgeries in outreaches. The reason is because those ones need far more care, follow-up care, post-op care. Like, there are some kind of surgeries that you need much more specialized care post-outreach. So we say, you know what, we could decide to develop an outreach model that gives us a two-sprint activity, which is what we are doing. A 40-day outreach, whereby part of it, of course, some part is the planning and evaluation period, right? Some part is the implementation period. So we have a first sprint where we carry out like some levels of activities, and then now plan for a second sprint where we now be carrying out the major surgeries and other things. So that's the other bit we've brought in, unlike the usual way that is usually the outreach happens just a period and that ends it. We are hoping that this can be a model in trying to reduce inequity in terms of access to care for people. Having said that, of course, it doesn't remove the core CMDA focus or mandate in those outreaches, which is about that we are there to win and be a Christian witness. So that is like standard. But what we are saying now is ensuring that we are able to offer much more quality care within the period that we are there.
Let the difference show in our daily activities, and some of us are doing that. Like in my department, I know we have about 2 or 3 CMDA members that I can say, yes, they are really making impact. You see that they are so active in the department that nothing can actually be done without their input. So those are the kind of things we want our members in every department to stand up to do. So we have members in all the departments doing a lot of work. And by God's grace, we will step up. And as other members join us, the impact will be greater. Thank you.
I think for us, it's just to keep on pushing the boundaries, to keep on challenging the system, to keep on shining the light, irrespective of how small. There are some things we've discussed, but I would rather say when it starts happening, we would rather allow it to announce than just talking about it. But I think our critical goal is to keep our eyes on this same thing where Jesus says, let your light so shine. And that for us is key. That is where our eyes are on, to keep on shining and being a Christian witness. And you know, for CMDA Cross River, one thing some years back we had told ourselves when we gathered and we were praying was, we said, Lord, can you use us as a case study to show everyone what you can do with a people? Because when we started, they graded us as a chapter that was it not viable or something? There was a time CMDA used to grade people. And so when we took up, we said, no, we are not this. We want to be like that. Those group, they said, we are not there, we are not menu, but this is where we are looking forward to being. So whatever they say, those people that are there should be doing, that's what we want to be doing. And I must tell you, God has helped us in that sense, because I mean, over the period of time, God has really helped us. So I think for us, our plan for next year is to keep shining, to keep challenging the status quo, and to keep on being a voice where we find ourselves, both to our patients, to our colleagues, to the institutions, and to our people, both home and abroad. I think that's our key message as a people, and what we're looking forward to doing in the next 1 year. Thank you.